Alright, folks, but you guys, idiot, we are back. Now, it has been a full day since my last video, and what you'll notice is that I've actually completed Chapter 2, Chapter 3, all three stars, and basically have not started Chapter 4, but at the start of the day, I've actually been going through, because I want to get all these character tokens as much as I can, so I went through all of Chapter 1, basically grabbed a whole bunch of stuff. There's something really cool that happens if you end up going to... if you end up not wanting to have to go through some of these levels again, you're in like a real rush. And part of that is you can click this quick loot button. Now I have 56 dungeon keys. Now the reason I have so many is because as I've been playing manually through them and not going through quick, if it's shiny, you click on it. And then a lot of times it does give you those dungeon keys. So along with that, along with opening the treasure chests, I've been getting those quite frequently. So right now I don't actually have to play through it. I can select quick loot, and what it will do is it will randomly generate. So you can have, you know, of course, bronze, silver, or gold, basically. So we got silver, which is awesome, because that means that we definitely were able to pick up the Life Reaper. Now, the Life Reaper is amazing. So he does a really good job. He's got a couple of really great attacks. It takes a long time to get him unless you get really lucky, which I have not done yet. So... with this, I wanted to be able to show you guys, though, the My Dungeon feature. So I knew I was going to hit level 10. Wanted to show you guys level 10. We're going to enter our name. As always. And look at that. Ta-da. No one's actually taken my name. That's awesome. So we can return often to collect gold. So it's pretty cool. So right here... we only have one gold available, no reason to get that. Now you can upgrade. So what I like to do, at least in the beginning, is basically straight up try and protect your gold as best you can. Now you collect these little hammers as you play through the games, and you can of course upgrade them. You get the hammers more so by, you know, the more times that you play through some of these levels. There's also a raid feature where you can actually raid and basically attack other people's, and you can kind of scout them to see who they have as part of their party, and see if you can maybe take them out. Damage reflection, so that guy's not good. Well, basically none of these guys seem like they're great. Like, they're gonna take us out. So, and you'll notice that, of course, the tournament ends in 14 hours. You have a rank right here, so we're rank 500, which is surprising because we just got in here. And then, you have a battle log of people that, you know, attack you and whatnot. So you do actually have a honor. So you can actually use honor stuff to actually unlock things. So for right now, I wouldn't really use it too much on this one. Usually I use honor scrolls for the summon. But what we can do is we can show you a little bit of this raid. So what we're going to do is we're going to scout, figure out which one we think we can defeat, which I'm going to guess is this one. So, and there's actually a quest right now that says... see, how many ranged attackers? Okay, so they have two. So that's actually going to be helpful. I'm trying to think who we can have. Those are all... okay, so we're going to face this guy because this just seems the best. And the way that we're going to put our guys in is we're going to do this, I believe. So with raiding, a lot of times, what I try and do for strategy is really suck a lot of times right before everything resets. And then when it resets, then I go and try and, you know, hit it really hard. Okay, this is not going to be fantastic. I really just need to have them survive for her to team mend. Thank goodness. So this guy's going to kick. Please don't kick him. Son of a gun. Okay. That was unfortunate. So what we're going to do is we're going to do Wall of Fire. And... this just sucks. Alright, so we're not doing very well. But I believe... and they dodged it. Wow. So anyway, so this guy right here, the Sifu, I think we have a quest where hopefully we can take him out. So... we're actually going to try and hit her. hopefully these guys get burned, which they do. If we actually hit him, we actually do extra damage. And now we have taunt, so now unfortunately we can only hit this guy. So we are going to get schooled with this. Invalid target, that's unfortunate. So there we go. Raid got absolutely destroyed by these guys, but honestly they were the worst. They were the best chance that we had. So that's not good. So let's go in here. Anyone? Oh, these guys we could definitely take on. That's really nice. So if you suck so much, which is awesome, you actually get to face some really, really good, easy characters. So we're gonna go through this. They actually have a really lucky with getting the Alchemist. Alchemist throws bombs. He does really good damage. So we're gonna try and take him out first, and that would be this guy right here. He does really good stuff. What? How are they all attacking first? Are my guys really that slow? Alright, anyways, wall of fire. And we are gonna try and get this guy out first. Perfect. He's gonna injure himself. Perfect. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually attack this guy. Because Ninja's only level 1, so he really shouldn't be doing that much damage. But surprisingly, he does a lot of damage. So we're going to try and take this guy out first. Okay. So boom, boom. Nice. Nice. Okay. So yay, we're going to actually win one. Wall of Fire is very helpful for a lot of melee attacked characters. So when you do this, you always get a bonus. 13 scrolls, which is awesome. Yeah, they're doing a fantastic job. I'll do that later. See if we can do one more raid. Those are all level 11s. Oh my gosh. 10, 10, 10. Okay, so I think what we're going to do here is... who are we facing? Melee, 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 range, range. Don't think the wall of fire is going to be that great. Yeah, he's going to be the best that we got right now. So, probably going to lose, but we'll play this just really quickly. Basically, at the end of this, I'm going to be unlocking a whole bunch of quests that I've completed, and then we'll kind of go through them and, you know, level up. Give you guys strategies kind of going moving forward. All these guys are all a higher level than us, and they always go for our healer, which really sucks. Wow, he went for the... wow. Whoa. Alrighty then. Got you. Perfect. Yep, so they dodged it, which is fine. We're going to use this on this guy. Ninja does the most damage, but honestly, he dodges a lot of the attacks, so I want to make sure that we do some damage to him. So we got him, and then we should be able to take him out with the damage. Just unfortunate. Now we can just attack her. Crit her? That's awesome. We might actually be able to win this. That is awesome. Wall of Fire for the win. Now, you guys may be asking, how did I get those two heroes? I got them actually through a summon. So I'll show you guys how I ended up doing that. Alright. Connect with your friends. I will actually do that at a later date. So basically, this portal, I used a heroic summon to actually... and I got really lucky and I got Sifu, which is this guy. And he does great, great damage. His Feet of Fury is awesome. It actually ignores all armor, and so does a really good job. So as you can see, we've got a lot of quests. I beat 10 dungeons. I collected 5 hero tokens. I won 2 PvP raids. Defeated the Flying Beasts. I obtained a player rank 10. And I defeated Yasmin Bloom in a dungeon or match. So I actually got one of her characters, which is awesome. So another couple things is gain 5 hero levels. We can actually do that right now. You'll see that they're timed and upgrade 4 heroes' abilities. So the easiest way to do this is to have a character that you have not leveled up, which is going to be Rogar. And we're going to increase it. Not so much because we're going to use him, but just to get extra stuff. And with his abilities, we can upgrade his abilities. Costs some gold. But what it's going to do is it's going to basically unlock the quest. So we have one more hero level to gain. Let's use someone else that we don't use regularly and level them up. There we go. Don't need to do anything more than that. Claim this. Probably going to gain a level here pretty soon. Yep, another level, so now we're level 11. And you can collect my dungeon gold 2 times. So the easiest way to do this is you have to wait an hour, but you basically collect this. Usually you'll want to wait a little bit longer, and then you'll collect it again. You'll basically get that dungeon quest super easy. It's an easy way to get these honor scrolls. Day trading, for a summon, we got to spend 20 gems. So the easiest way to do that is to find a 25 one for either the items. So there's nothing here for the gold, so we'll actually get a stamina. Purchase the stamina. It's an easy 25. We're gonna do some day trading, claim that one. And they always have this one, like, win 2 PvP raids with a beast and a warrior on your team. Well, we don't have one, so it's not something that we can really do just yet. And this lady Nimriel is awesome. But you have to kind of do a whole bunch of stuff. So we'll be doing that a little bit. We're actually going to probably get that one here really quickly. Because we're going to go to the portal. And you saw that we got a summon. So let's summon here. Got silver. Okay, so got some evos. And you see we got the dungeon key. So that was kind of nice. Ooh, nice evo. So what we're actually going to do here is I always like to keep about 100 to 200 gems, and we have way over that. So I'm actually going to use this summon to hopefully get a character. Hopefully we get a gold. Yes, we got a gold. So usually with a gold, it means you unlock an actual hero, which it would be great. And we didn't, okay, but we got Overlord. Wow, okay. That's still pretty good. That's a lot of nice tokens. I would have liked to unlock the guy. But unfortunately, we didn't do that. Let's go to Hero Drops. So you can either do tokens or a full unlock. And that's actually how I unlocked... where's the guy? Sifu. I actually unlocked Sifu. And he's a 3-star. So he's actually really, really good. And actually, since I'm doing this, let's actually summon this. We're going to hope to get something good. Ugh, no, we just got Ice Pick. That's unfortunate. So we didn't get anything actually really that great there, but now I got to build up my gems, which is easy to do. Something I also want to do is I want to do some of these summons. I'll do about 2 of them, and hoping to get something good. Oh, Bovis Eldoro. I would love to get the Matador or the. If I could get him, that'd be great. Sir William, he's also a really good one. Sume, not so good. Willow Swift. Sume. Yes! Bovis Eldoro. Sweet. So we're actually not going to do that. And if I remember correctly, Bovis Eldoro is actually something that we can get at some point. Where's Bovis Eldoro? He may be in the next chapter, in this chapter 4 right here, but there's definitely one where you can get Bovis Eldoro. So what we'll do is we're actually going to go through the portal, and we'll spend 1 more. I think we'll wrap up the video. Silver. See, we get a ton of dungeon keys. Now those evos, don't disregard those medium evos. Those are really nice. Evos are definitely something that are nice, especially the medium ones. Like, that medium green one was great. Okay, didn't get nothing too great here. Yep. These are all kind of average. Yes! Okay, we got Bovis Eldoro. Yes, yes, yes. That's really what I was hoping for. Whew, this is awesome. So, great thing about that is Bovis Eldoro is ready to unlock. He's only a one star, but he does Stampede, which is great. So, and it lowers their energy by one. So it's really tough, but it can be really helpful. And so you'll notice here that he actually takes quite a bit of Evos to unlock. But when you do unlock him, he can regenerate health every turn. So this guy is definitely something that we're going to save up our Evos to ascend. Aside from that, we also have Yasmin Bloom, which we actually, because she's our only healer at this point, we actually do want to ascend her, because she actually, the next one she has is going to be Cure. So let's ascend her. Yep. So, and basically then their next ascend is going to take quite a bit of stuff, which we don't really have the ability yet. Now you'll notice that we could also do Stone Fist, which is really, he's really nice, but I'm going to wait. There's a couple water ones that I think coming up that I would really, really like. So great thing about this is we are going to increase his stuff. Boom. So I definitely want him as part of my party. And what you can do is for your dungeon, you can actually set up defense. So the defenders right now, we're going to get rid of her. We're going to put Eldoro. We're going to get rid of the healer because everyone always seems to get her first. And we're going to go for him. So we got no really fast people, but we got a lot of attack power. We got one more. Do we want to go for it? Do we want to go for it, guys? Do we want to go for it? Do we think we can do it? Do we think we can do it? I think I can. So we're going to actually get rid of her. Put Bovis Eldoro. We're going to try this. Now, the reason I'm getting rid of the healer is because she tends to be focused and she tends to get taken out almost immediately, which really sucks. So they're going to do, of course, damage, and she went for him, which is great. Great, great, great. Nice, nice. I am totally cool with the way that this has started. So as you can see right now, she did her best attack right here. So we're really not going to focus her. We're actually going to focus this guy because he hasn't done his special attack yet. And if we can attack him and take him out, that means his special attack isn't played. We'll do Wall of Fire. Great, because these next two guys do physical attacks. And we're really hoping that even though he's going to hit all of us, okay, he didn't actually get hit, which sucks. So this is Bovis Eldoro. This is Stampede. Okay, we missed, but we took away their energy, which is very, very helpful. Now again, we're gonna take down their defenses, so I think we're gonna get rid of hers. She does pretty decent damage. And she's a ranged attack. The other ones can get fire on them, she cannot. So we're really gonna try and hit her first. It doesn't look like we're unfortunately able to do. So she's probably going to have another attack and knock out one of our guys. Oh, she didn't. That's nice. So Wall of Fire is fantastic. Now this guy, Ignis the Mad, I got him through luck again, through one of the portals. So that was just really lucky. He does extra damage, which is great. And one of the reasons that I'm doing this at the end is because if you can beat Rage, you're going to gain ranks. And the next time that this rank is done is actually at the end of today. So the main reason I did that was because if you check the leaderboard, I kind of want to stay at this leaderboard spot. So we're at 2. I would love to stay at that leaderboard spot, basically get some bonuses. So ended up getting quite a bit of rewards. So we ascended a hero, we spent 600 or more gems, collected 7 heroes, spent 50,000. So we got 52. You also notice here at the bottom that you can defeat people and you'll basically get their stuff. So you've seen that. Before we do anything, we actually have enough scrolls to do an honor summon. So these drops are tokens or a full unlock. We're really going to be hoping for a full unlock of any of these guys. We're really going to hope for it. I've been really lucky, so I don't think that I will get it. We'll see. Yeah, we didn't. So we didn't get it, but we actually got quite a bit of good stuff. So we got gems, which is always nice, and we got Black Diamond, which is really nice. Mango Jaw, not too much, but we also got this Evo, which is going to be very helpful. So that's where I like to use my honor summons on them. Hope you guys enjoy this. I will probably be back in a day or two, and I'll show you guys a little bit of what happens once you get to you finish this chapter, you get up to chapter 5, and you start kind of building up your characters. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. This has been Pitching Ace 88. Over and out.